actually so na I wanted to run away from it kasi hindi talaga sanay sa Tagalog songs. I was a little scared kung ano talaga yung reaction of the crowd at saka parang hindi pa ako ready to get feedback from people about when I came to my Tagalog. But I said, you know, screw it. I've been here for, you know, a couple of years and I think it's overdue na that I should make a Tagalog song. At since hindi pwede ako mag-create ng, you know, my own Tagalog song, my own composition of Tagalog song, I was like, fine, I'll just allow somebody to write me a Tagalog song and I'll just add to it. So the rap in the song is the only thing I was able to contribute to the song. And obviously the rap is in English. But I feel that this song, I didn't look at it to have so much potential, but I believed in the process, and by the time we finished the song, I believed that it was something beautiful. I don't know, every time I listen to it, I can actually listen to it. When it was pitched to me, there was the original guy singing it, and that one. But when I first heard it, I said to myself, I don't think that this would suit me. At first, I said that, but this is a little too much for me. And then I listened to my record company. They said, Migo, you don't have a Tagalog song yet, and I wouldn't offer you a song that I would think na hindi mo kaya. I honestly think that you can make this song work. Sinabi niya sa akin na, it may sound weird now because it's not in your voice, but if you can add your personality to the song, then we can make something special. So I recorded that song without expecting anything. I didn't expect it to sound good. I didn't expect it to sound amazing. I just did it. I just did my best. And by the time we finished it, we had the finished product. And first time I said that, I said, I am taking my job seriously that I did when I first started. Kasi syempre, young-minded pa rin ako nung nag-start ako sa GMA. At parang mahina lang. Like, I just came back from the starstruck. Mm-hmm. And then when I was dropped into like Cantaja, parang nililito ako na parang, medyo mabilis yung process. Parang, parang hindi ko kaya yung Tagalog yung time na yun at saka yung talent ko sa acting dati sa Tagalog din medyo hindi pa ako rin talaga sa lahat ng mga assignments and opportunities that GMA was giving me. Unlike now, medyo actually I would say that malaki talaga yung improvement, especially when it comes to Tagalog and also acting, just because I've given more time in investing not only in my craft but also in myself, and I've finally been able to actually accept Philippines as home and not just as foreign land. Parang medyo weirded out na wala masyado akong kaibigan dito dahil Tagalog sila talaga ako, but I'm finally being able to become one with my roots. I was born here talaga. I can kind of understand that. For my upcoming songs, not the ones that will come after this, but maybe by mid this year, I'll be venturing into a little bit more of a darker image. I'm not so much of your boy next door anymore. Medyo parang it's more darker, but mas ako to.
Would you say that's more you?
Well, yes. And I think definitely with the chance now that I've turned 18, gives me a little bit more understanding from fans din kapag bakit ako nag-change ng image. So I really waited for the right time kasi I didn't want my fans to parang magbiglaan na parang, what the heck? Where did this come from? Why did it become dark all of a sudden? So at least I also want to show the fans also na sino talaga si Migo Adecer / Douglas Adecer. So when it comes to acting, that's really Migo Adecer, and my real self can get into there. But But when it comes to music, I can express who I am really and very behind the scenes. Hi guys, it's Migo Adecer, and I just want to invite you to SUNTOK SA BUWAN. You can find it on Spotify, and also if you go on YouTube, you'll be able to find the Spotlight live video, which is also exclusive to Jimmy Records. Guys, maraming salamat sa support mo. At ito talaga yung first Tagalog song, and first but not last, I'll be definitely making some more. And sana you're gonna be able to like the song and kind of vibe to it. Catch me at 9:15 after Kambal Karibal on the one that got away as Sam, your dearest Samuel Isaac. And I forgot the last name, but it's cool. And akakalaki yung kapatid ni Zoe. Pretty fun, since we have more crazy, more sexy, and funny material coming our way, and I feel like The One That Got Away is a TV show that will stay on 9:15 for a longer time.